Hey guys, good morning. Thank you for joining me today. I'm Rinske Dauna and this is my art channel. Today I will be working on Miracle Life Painting number 4. I can't believe we're here already. Just 2 more to go. Sarah Taylor chose today's subject and she chose Yin Yang. I think it's a perfect topic to work on because there are so many positives, negatives, and every day we need to find a new balance. I've thought long and hard about this painting, but I decided to make literally a yin-yang design because babies, they love the contrast, black and white, and after a couple of months, they're really drawn to graphics and designs. So I will be creating a fun design in the yin-yang. It won't be fully symmetrical, but just a little bit playful. And then, of course, for the parents, it's the reminder of all the positives, negatives, and finding the balance. All right, while I make this Yin Yang painting, I will continue our story. I left off the last time. Tycho is born 29 weeks. We are in the post-intensive care after being 1 week in the NICU, the intensive care. And he just needs to grow and develop. He is in the incubator and we only pick him out of the incubator for kangarooing, skin on skin contact. But after a couple of weeks, just going back and forth to the hospital, it got time to tick on some milestones. And these are super small, but for us, huge milestones. So one day it was on 34 weeks of pregnancy. We came in the hospital in the room. And they told us, Tycho can get out of the incubator, he can control his temperature, and he will get just a little crib. And after that, we will bathe him. Normally, we would just wash him. And also, he couldn't have any clothes. So suddenly, this day, out of the incubator, getting a bath, and wearing his first clothes. Whoa, what? A day was this. I'm still getting the chills, really beautiful. So I will show you a picture of Tycho here. And this, you must imagine, it's a sink. It's not a normal tub. And he loved being in the water, which he missed for so long, right? Because he wasn't in the uterus anymore. And of course, we did not expect having Tycho so soon and so early that we only had clothes for normal newborns, so all the clothes we had were way too big and we weren't prepared to get clothes for him because we were so used that he didn't wear clothes, just a diaper, and was in the incubator. But here he is laying in his new crib, his new little home. But what a beautiful day this was. Because before, the weeks before, we were living day by day, really. And now we could look more into the future. Things were really happening. He was progressing so, so fast. And things from that point on really went super fast. We were still for 5 weeks or something in the hospital. But like I said, we could now look more forward to the future. For instance, he was still fed by tube, but one day he was giving us signs he was ready to start drinking from the breast or from bottle because he was skin on skin kangarooing with Wouter and he started to try to touch his nipple and tweak a little. So that was a sign for us. We can try and give him normal breastfeeding or by bottle. And how beautiful is this? It's a natural instinct these little babies have, an old baby have. But imagine not doing that for so long and suddenly your baby is ready and feels that instinct and has that instinct. What a proud moment this was for us. And Tycho was really on track on the things he needed to do at the certain times they wanted him to do those things. We are the lucky ones here, really. And in the meanwhile, we needed to balance so many things and also planning was a huge part of this process. And if you know me and Wouter, then you know we can't plan. We don't like it and we can't do it. But in this process, you are really forced and you really need to think about what is best for us, ourselves, our baby, and our environment. So I will break a couple of these things down so you understand what needs to be balanced here. So first I would like to say is that when your baby or your child is in the hospital, then you worry so much, even though things are going well, there's not a lot of space besides that to do other things. So for instance, I have shot a lot of videos for you guys in the meantime, and they were ready to publish on YouTube, but I had just a super hard time to just click on the button, publish my video. I had them lined up, but somehow I could only manage to do it one time a week. Imagine how full. So Wouter and me, we decided that we needed to take care of ourselves, our relationship, and us as a family. We could room in with Tycho, so that means we could sleep with him and be there 24/7 really. But our house was a 10-minute drive. Also, the beds in the hospital are not so comfortable and we couldn't lay together, Wouter and me then. And we decided to go home every night and sleep at home. It was for us the decision, do we start recovering ourselves, become strong, talk with each other, be with each other, just me and Wouter, and be the best persons we can be the next day for our baby boy and have the most energy we can get. I think it was the best decision for us here. But the downside of this is there's so much guilt involved, really. So it's hard on me still. Because you need to leave your baby every day. There's no right or wrong here, but I'm so glad we made this decision, because when Tycho came home, we were rested and fully recovered, and we knew what we could do. But that said, because Tycho came so early, we did not have the third trimester, and we planned in the third trimester to make his room ready, to buy all his clothes, all his stuff, and also do some baby courses. Well, the baby courses we got in the hospital, I can tell you that, we were experts with our baby. But yeah, what do you decide? Do you decide to finish Tycho's room and not be with him, or be with him and don't have a room ready when he's coming home? So of course we have amazing friends and family. They offered to make us a big list what we all needed for a baby, and they came one day, they got all the stuff we picked out and made his room ready, and we can't thank them enough. But also some super small things we forgot to eat. You know, so we were there full days with Tycho, you know, from morning till evening. And then you need to do groceries, make dinner. You just don't have time for that. So my mom, she made us every day dinner. We could just shove it in the oven. And there we had this most delicious food. Because if you know my mom, she makes the best food you have ever eaten. So mom, if you're watching this, why did you stop? We need more dinners. We have a baby now at home. So these are just a couple of examples you need to balance out, but there's a positive part and a negative part, a good and a bad. So much more I can think of, but I need to stop somewhere, right? I can't imagine as well having already a kid at home like Sarah does. So I'm very excited to hear a story about Yin Yang, because I think she will be talking about that as well. I would like to thank you all for watching and all the support, love, and the stories you are sharing. It means so, so much for us. And this is baby Tycho right now. He's really smiling. And if he smiles, how can you be unhappy? We are so, so proud of this kid. Next week will be the last episode of the Miracle Life Paintings. This is gonna be a beautiful end product, I think. I still need to make it, but I have it in my head. I hope you tune in next week, Wednesday, 12 p.m. EST time.